Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. Before watching this video, we suggest that you watch the video overview of 5 wave types in science. Waves are all around us and play a major part in our technology. For this reason, we study wave details in our science courses. In this video, we'll discuss classes of electromagnetic waves, mechanical wave groups, what a physical medium is, propagation and oscillation, transverse and longitudinal waves, and the definition of a wave. We'll start by discussing electromagnetic waves. We divide specific electromagnetic waves into one of 7 classes based on the length of their waves in a vacuum. In the prior video, we gave examples of how we commonly experience radio waves, microwaves, infrared, and visible light waves. The 3 other classes of electromagnetic waves are ultraviolet, X-rays, and gamma rays. We commonly use these as follows. We use ultraviolet waves inside our air ducts to kill harmful organisms circulating in the air, such as viruses. We use X-rays in medical imaging, such as getting an X-ray to show the condition of our bones and teeth. And we produce gamma rays in nuclear power plants. A key feature of all electromagnetic waves is that they can travel through a vacuum. A vacuum refers to a volume of space that has no atoms in it. Outer space is a very good approximation for a vacuum. For example, if the inside of this vehicle was like outer space, then there would be only 1 atom inside it. But here on Earth, it's filled with air, so there are about this number of atoms inside it. Here are the classic examples of electromagnetic waves traveling in a vacuum. Satellites send radio waves through outer space to our GPS-enabled devices. Astronomers study the origins of the universe by detecting microwaves in outer space. The sun generates infrared waves, visible light waves, and ultraviolet waves that travel across 93 million miles of outer space to reach us. We experience the infrared waves as heat, the visible light waves as brightness, and the ultraviolet waves as sunburns. Black holes radiate X-rays and gamma rays as beams from their north and south poles, which travel across outer space. Although all electromagnetic waves can travel in a vacuum, this is not unique to them. For example, gravitational waves can also travel in a vacuum. These gravitational waves traveled across many trillions of miles of outer space to reach our instruments on Earth. Next, we'll discuss mechanical waves. Unlike electromagnetic waves that are all similar to each other, mechanical waves are a very diverse group. There are many ways to group these. We'll use 4 groups: string waves, surface waves, membrane waves, and acoustic waves. String waves include motion on strings, ropes, or wires that may look like the wave is traveling. Or, the string may look like a wave is not traveling, but instead is just vibrating in place, as on this guitar. Water waves cover most of the Earth's surface. There is enormous variety among their size, speed, and shape, but in physics, we consider all of these to be a type of surface wave. Membrane waves include motion on flags or cloths that move freely. And it also includes motion on membranes that are held tight around all of their edges, like on a drum. This bird is communicating with other birds by using sound waves that travel through the air. Sound waves may also travel through liquids, such as water, which is why we can hear this diver. In physics, we consider sound waves to be a subgroup of a larger group, which are called acoustic waves. Other acoustic waves include seismic waves originating deep in the Earth, which we may feel as a shake during an earthquake. Many times, these different wave groups interact with each other. For example, when string waves and membrane waves are part of musical instruments, then they may create acoustic waves, which we then hear as sound waves. Although all of these waves are very different, they all have one thing in common, which is that they can only exist in a physical medium. Next, we'll discuss what a physical medium is. A physical medium is made of many atoms that can transmit a wave. As we showed in the prior video, we can't hear the alarm clock ringing when it's in a vacuum. But when we let the air back into the chamber, then we can hear the alarm clock. This tells us 2 things. First, that air is a physical medium. And second, that sound waves are a mechanical wave. What we commonly call air is a collection of atoms in the gas state. A physical medium can also be in the liquid state, which is why milk waves only exist in milk and would be impossible if there were no atoms around, such as in a vacuum. And a physical medium can also be in the solid state. Although electromagnetic waves can travel through a vacuum, they can also travel through some physical mediums, depending on the class of wave. For example, visible light waves can travel through a gas medium like air. It can travel through a liquid medium like water. And it can travel through a solid medium like transparent glass. But it can't travel through a solid medium made of bricks, like the wall. Next, we'll discuss propagation and oscillation. When we look at mechanical waves, we can observe there are two types of motion. The most obvious motion is that the waves appear to be traveling. We call this motion propagation. In this case, the waves are propagating towards the shore. Here, the waves are propagating away from this athlete. In this animation of sound waves, we can see the waves are propagating away from the speaker. The second motion is called oscillation. This refers to the relatively small distances that atoms move within the physical medium as each wave propagates through them. With these water waves, the oscillation is the up and down movement of the water that makes the boats bob, whereas the propagation is the movement of the waves towards the shore. In this spring, the oscillations are the up and down movement, whereas the propagation is towards the pole and away from the pole. In this spring, the oscillations are the back and forth movement, whereas the propagation is from one person to the other. In this animation of sound waves, we can see the particles in the air oscillating back and forth as each wave propagates past them. Please focus on one red particle, and you'll see that it only moves a short distance back and forth, compared with the much greater distance that the wave propagates. Next, we'll introduce transverse and longitudinal waves. Transverse waves oscillate the physical medium in a direction that is perpendicular to the direction of propagation. This flag is oscillating towards and away from us in the y-axis, but the waves are propagating in the x-axis towards the right. So these are transverse waves. These planes are oscillating vertically, but the waves are propagating horizontally. So there are transverse waves here. In contrast to transverse waves, longitudinal waves oscillate the physical medium in a direction that's parallel to the wave propagation. Sound waves are the classic example of longitudinal waves. We sometimes call these compression waves because we see areas of compression that are surrounded by areas that are spread out, called rarefaction. In this spring, the oscillations are in the x-axis, and the wave propagation is also in the x-axis. So these are longitudinal waves. Some mechanical waves are made of both transverse and longitudinal waves. The most common example is water. If we could look at some molecules of water, we would see a motion very similar to this. Please focus on the top orange dot. Since it travels in a circle, that means some of the time it's going up and down, which means there is a transverse wave. But other times it goes in a forwards and backwards motion, which means there's a longitudinal wave. Likewise, in another surface wave, such as those made by some earthquakes, we see circular motion, which tells us there is both transverse and longitudinal wave motion. All electromagnetic waves are transverse waves. The red waves represent the oscillating electric field, and the blue waves represent the oscillating magnetic field. That's why we call them electromagnetic waves. Now we're ready to define a wave. A wave is a propagating disturbance. That disturbance could be in a small, simple physical medium and caused by something we do. Like mechanical waves in a physical medium, such as these surface waves being created by a child jumping into a swimming pool. Or that disturbance could be on a scale that may be beyond our imaginations, like electromagnetic waves being created by a black hole and traveling for billions of years across the seemingly empty vacuum of outer space. We thank the following people and institutions for sharing their amazing images. Here's a summary of this topic and some additional information. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.